Hello students, today I am here to teach you something maths about mathematics, that is coordinate geometry. In the first part I have taught you about the reflections of the line, then now today I am going to tell you something about the slope. What do you mean by slope? But before starting, I want to tell you again, go through the videos from the starting to the ending, then only you can understand the subject. And beside this, always remember to give a comment for how you enjoyed the video and what you gain. Give your comments. Your comments will encourage us to give you much more improvised video. So I myself, Kuna, from Kuna's Horizon, again want to tell you, give your comments and give your valuable subscription to make the channel powerful, and your comments to make the videos much more improvised and much more knowledge in that video, so that I can put much more videos in that video. So see here, what I am going to tell you is inclination or angle of inclination. First, before knowing about the slope, first we have to know what is known as inclination and angle of inclination. If this one is y and this one is y dash and this is x dash and this is x, and a line goes through the x-axis and y-axis, and this is the O, and this angle is known as theta. This is the angle theta. So then what is the angle of inclination? What is angle of inclination? Angle of inclination. What is angle of inclination? Inclination of a line or angle of inclination is the angle made by the part of the line above x-axis with the positive direction of x-axis, and this is theta. Next, remember, whatever angle of inclination, number one is the angle of inclination is usually denoted by theta. The inclination theta of the line always lies between 0 to 180 degree. Inclination of a horizontal line parallel to x-axis or coinciding with x-axis is defined to be 0 or 180. Number 2 point is the inclination of a horizontal line means line parallel to the x-axis or coinciding with the x-axis. Then if this line is like this way, then this is parallel to the x-axis, and if it is on the x-axis, here it will coincide. So here the angle is always 0 or 180 degree. Next, inclination of a vertical line parallel to y-axis, number 3. The inclination of a vertical line parallel to the y-axis, like this way. So this is y and this is y dash, and this is x dash and this is x. So when these two are parallel, at that time it may be either coinciding with y-axis or away from the y-axis. At that time, the angle is always 90 degree with the x-axis. So the inclination is 90 degree, which we call perpendicular to the x-axis. Then the next thing which I am telling you, coming to the point, that is slope. What do you mean by slope? What do you mean by slope? Slope is the positive tangent. Slope is the positive tangent or of the theta. Positive tangent with the are known as the which angle we defined x or theta. That should be positive angle with the x-axis. Slope is the positive angle with the x-axis. Tangent of the positive angle with the x-axis. Tangent of theta with the x-axis, but it should be positive, not in the direction of the negative. So see here, if this one is theta, then this will be the slope, the positive theta, and the tangent of theta gives you the slope, which is also known as gradient. So tangent of the angle of inclination is defined as the slope of a non-vertical line. The slope of a non-vertical line is generally denoted by M. Slope of a non-vertical line is generally denoted by N, M. So slope of the line in the figure is equal to tan theta is equal to M, denoted by M. Tangent of the positive angle with x-axis. Always remember, slope of a vertical line is undefined. Slope of a vertical line is undefined because it is 1090 and it cannot be defined. Then the next case is slope of a line independent of the direction. Slope of the line is independent of the direction of the line. It does not indicate any direction of the line. So slope of the line is always independent of the line. So if we will write here this one as A and this one as B, if you will write slope of AB will be equal to slope of BA. This is x-axis and this one is y-axis. So slope of AB is always equal to slope of BA. Remember, now another thing, the condition of parallelism can also be defined by the method of slope. Number one is the for parallelism, slope of both the lines of both the lines will be equal. That means the slope of first line is equal to M1, then the slope of second line is M2, then both the lines will be parallel if and only both the slopes will be equal, that is M1 is equal to M2. Then the perpendicularism. Perpendicularism. Slope of two lines perpendicular to each other. Means M1 into M2 is equal to always -1. For the condition of perpendicularism, the product of both the slopes should be equal to -1. That means the slope of first line if is m1 and the slope of second line if is m2, then the product of m1 into m2 is equal to minus 1. So this is all about the slopes. So with this I come to the end of this subject. So this is slope. So in the third part of coordinate geometry, I will give you the I will teach you about the equation of the lines. Equation of the lines. But before that, go through the part 1 and the part 2 slope, so that you can understand the equation of the line, which is in the third part, nicely. So always remember, go through the lessons, go through the videos from the starting to the ending, and give your views, give your comments in the comment box. But overall, always remember, so give your subscriptions, give your valuable subscriptions, and make the channel very much powerful, so that you can learn more, so that I can give all my potential to the videos, so that you can learn much more and more. So with this I end it, and I wait for the third part, which is equation of which will come, which I am coming with you with the equation of the line. I myself, Kunna, from the Kunna's Horizon, always telling you, subscribe the channel, and in the third part, never forget to view the third part, which will bring you the equation of the line. About the equation of the line. What is equation? You have read. I will teach you what is the, how can we define a line with the equation of the line in the third part. So be alert and go for the videos. Thank you.